need what the generator
for the synchronous speed and all those kind of things. We talked about those kind of things. Now, we want to be a little bit more to the equivalent circuit for the induction machine. As if you remember, I mentioned that induction machines are like a transformer, but the only difference is the secondary transformer, we have a primary and secondary, they are both stationary, they are not moving. But in induction machine, you can assume the stator is the primary and the rotor is the secondary. So the secondary winding is rotating, is moving. Now, there are other, one more difference, you know, we went through the single phase transformer. Single phase transformer, we discussed everything. But induction machines are like a three-phase. There are three-phase systems, the one you're talking about. I didn't talk about the three-phase transformer. So basically here to kind of use the same idea of single phase for the three-phase transformer, just think about it. You have three single phase transformers. This one is a phase A. Whatever you have in phase A, every angle is shifted 120 degrees, is a phase B, and another 120 degrees is going to be phase C. So basically, we use the same, whatever we need in the single phase transformer for the three phase, you know, transformer, only there is a phase B and phase C. Here is the circuit. So you can see lots of similarity, you know, here with the transformer. And everything I'm saying here is a per phase. Per phase means this is for phase A. We'll have the same thing exactly for phase B. The same thing exactly for phase C. But we're not going to solve phase B and phase C. Why? Because when I'm in phase A, I shift it 120 degrees and phase B. Shift it 240 degrees and phase C. So basically, I'm going to talk only about the phase A here. What I'm drawing here is for the motoring move, because the current is coming to the motor. Like a transformer, this is a this is an IC. I'll call it IM and IC here. And NSNR. NS is the number of turns in phase A of transformer of a stator. NR is the number of turns in the phase A of the rotor. Right? Let's call this one ER, E rotor, and this is the I rotor. And say NS to the NR, or sometimes they say A to 1. If you go with A to 1, if you go with A to 1, A is NS over NR. You can say NSNR, or you can say A to 1. This is kind of easier, normalized. You know, A to 1, and A is NS over NR. Let's talk about all these parameters in this circuit, what they are. Can someone tell me what's RF?
Mm-hmm. This is the resistance of the state of wind, right? Like the exactly transformer. If you go back into transformer, right? We say this is the primary, it has a R1 and X1, right? R was the resistance of this winding. RS is the resistance of the stator winding, phasing, right? And everything is per phase. You can say exactly the same thing for phase B, exactly the same thing for phase C. RS is the stator resistance. What is the XS? Leakage inductance. We call it leakage inductance of the. Remember when we have flux here, part of it is going to go here, a little bit is going to go here, right? This is the leakage flux, right? Which is going to cause the X. So basically, this is the leakage inductance of the stator winding. Resistor of the stator winding, leakage inductance of the stator winding. How about these two? Let's go for the easier one. How about these two? RR is the resistance of the rotor winding, right? XR is the leakage inductance of rotor winding, right? And this is for phase A. How about RC? What was RC in this circuit? Remember? This is for transformer, right? The only difference here is short, because remember I said they are kind of both sides, they are shorted when I talked about the storm case. So here it's short, right? RC was what? Representing the core loss of the transformer. What about here? RC is representing what? The core loss of the rotor or stator? Why stator? Why not rotor? We talked about it. You said what frequency would be induced in the rotor? SFS, right? And S usually is a small number. It's like 2%, 3%. Let's say F, a stator frequency is 60 Hz, so it's going to be 1.2, 1.3. You saw one example, right? The frequency in the rotor is very, very, very small. And we know the hysteresis loss and eddy current loss, they are both proportional to F square, right? So basically, on the rotor, we have a small, maybe 1% of the total core loss is in the rotor and the rest in the stator, right? So basically, this is representing the core loss in the stator, right? RC is representing the core loss of the motor in the stator, because the rotor doesn't have the core loss. How about XM? XM. That's a magnetization inductance, right? That's a magnetization inductance we call it induction machine. Let's call it induction machine. Basically, this is the flux is going to link these two winding together, right? If you remember, XN comes from this flux, right? XL comes from this flux. XM comes from this. The flux is linking these two winding together, right? Magnetization flux. We call it magnetization flux. Magnetization inductance. Inductance of the phasing. How about this current? Let's start with this one. What is the VS? This is the phase A stator voltage. For example, if they said, we said the induction machine, the one we are talking about, there are three-phase system, right? So when we have a three-phase system by default, when they say this system is, for example, 100 volts, what's that voltage? It's a line-to-line RMS voltage, right? That was the default. If you have a three-phase system, they tell us a voltage and they don't say anything, means that's a line-to-line RMS voltage, right? They said this induction machine is a 208 volt machine. What does it mean? How much is this voltage? 208 is square root of 3. Right? Because 208 is a line voltage, right? They said this machine is a 208 volt, right? I said this is a per phase. This is a phase A, right? This is a phase A. This is line voltage, right? How much is the phase A voltage? 208 over square root of 3, right? So this is the phase A stator voltage, right? IS. What is IS? Phase A stator current, right? I shouldn't say phase A. Phase stator phase current, because it could be phase A, phase B, or phase C, right? This is a phase current going to the system. How about IR? This is root of phase current, right? Root of phase current. Now, and we know what the IC is, the IC is the core loss component of the stator current, right? And IM is the magnetization part of the current, right? And we call this one excitation current, right? This is exactly like transformer, excitation current, magnetization current, and core loss current, right? History. Now, if the machine is not rotating, if the machine is not rotating, if the rotor is not rotating, this is exactly like a transformer, right? Because both winding, they are not moving, right? They're exactly like a transformer. When the machine is not rotating, the rotor is not rotating, they call it block rotor. That's a term they use, block rotor. We're going to talk about that one later. That's one of the tests we do. Block rotor, for some reason, the rotor is blocked. And if you remember, I told you, this is a very dangerous case for the machine. You know, if the rotor is blocked, and you put a big voltage here, what is going to happen? This current is going to go very, very high. Remember when we talked about the starting of the DC motor? At the beginning, we say the back EMF is zero. If you put a big voltage, no starter, what is going to happen? It's going to burn the machine. So block rotor, if we have a block rotor, let me write it here. Let's call this one. Let's put it this way. E1 is NS. NS is the number turn of the stator winding. NS F flux is going to be. That's the equation we had, you know, in the, I don't know which chapter we talked about this, but maybe we have a sine wave form. This is this, we are going to have this much in this voltage. And it's simple. You know how to get this equation? If you remember, we say E is N dt over dt, right? If you go back here, and you say, for example, if you have a winding like this, this is N, and you put a sine voltage here, right? Or you have a sine, go this way, if you have a phi, phi m sine of omega t, right? If you could calculate ERMS, ERMS is going to be 4.4 nf phi m. Let's do this one here. It's going to be, what's going to be the dt over dt is going to be omega phi m, right? That's, I don't care about the rest, you know. There is a cosine of omega here, right? Now put it here. How much is the E? E is going to be N omega phi m sum, right? How much is this one? Omega is 2 pi f, right? N 2 pi f plus sum. How much is the ERMS? We had this one before. You don't have to write it. 2 pi n f divided by f, right? Which is going to be this one. So we have one winding here. How much is the induced voltage here? It's going to be 4.44 NSF Pn. How much is the ER? Somebody tell me. How much is the ER? Let's call this one FS. FS, I mean, stator, you know, frequency. How much is the ER? Can somebody tell me how much is the ER? Tell me. So basically, this one is the same, because over there we have also sine wave, right? 4.4, and the flux is going to be nr. The only difference is nr, because the number of turns you have more than is nr. And instead of fs, is going to be fr, right? That's the rotor frequency. Frequency of the current or voltage induced in the rotor. It's the frequency of the voltage or current in the stator, right? What was the relation between these two? What was the relation between these two?
That's minus R.
Right? FR was
SF,
XFF, right? This is when the machine is rotating, right? If the machine is, if the rotor is blocked, say omega m zero, we call it EB, E block. Block rotor. How much is the EB? Somebody tell me. EB is going to be here. Basically, EB is ER when omega m is 0. How much is the EB? Can somebody tell me? How much is the EB?
Zero.
It's like a transformer, right? It's like a real transformer, it's not moving. Basically, instead of FR, let's just go that way. However, when the machine is stopped, is not moving, how much is S? What was the S definition? Let's go back. I think it was NS minus N over NS, right? Am I right?
Mm-hmm.
If the motor is not moving, how much is N?
Zero.
Zero. So basically, how much is S?
One.
So if S is one, FR is equal to FS, right? Basically, EB is going to be 4.4.4 NR FS here, right? Or you can take it the other way. You say, forget the slip and those things. I have two windings, the second winding is not moving. If the frequency in the first winding is FS, how much is the frequency in the second winding? That's the same, right? When we had a transformer, if the primary was 60 Hertz, how much was the frequency of the secondary? The same thing, was 60 Hertz, right? So you can go that way or you can use this equation. Say, you can put here the omega m equals to 0 means S is equal to 1, right? Now they call it E block rotor. E block. Just, I want to make sure I'm covering everything. Now, what is the relation between this EB and this EI? In my circuit, I have ER, right? And this one is rotating. This winding is rotating with a speed of rotor, right? My intention is to draw a new circuit with EB. Why EB? Because EB will do exactly like a transformer. EB means the machine is not rotating, right? So later on, if I want to bring the parameters to this side, simply I can use the equation for the transformer. So whatever is coming here, I should time it by A squared, right? My intention is to move from ER to EB, because EB I can treat it exactly like a transformer, like a regular transformer we talked about. Now, look at here. We said EB is equal to ER when omega m is 0, but in general, if I wanted in general, what's the relation between this ER and that EB? Isn't it EB equal to SER? Right? FR. Replace it with SFS. Right? So it's S times this one with FS, which is the EB, right? So basically I can say here. ER basically is S EB. Right? Here. See, this is the S. FS, right? Time this one by S. It's going to be SFS, right? How much is the SFS? It's the FR, right? If I replace here with FR, what is this? This is ER, right? Now I'm going to go draw the circuit again. Before going there, we have an XD also. This is again for block rule. How much is the XD? What's the definition of XD? That's the leakage inductance of the rotor per phase when the rotor is blocked, right? So these values are different. Why different? Why XR is different from XD? Why these two are different? Can somebody tell me why XR is different from XD?
Frequencies
are different, exactly. So XB is a omega L is going to be omega LB. This one is going to be omega again LR. LR and LB, they are the same, right? Because inductance is not depending on frequency. But X is based on what frequency you have, right? For this case, this one is going to be 2 pi SFS. For this one, it's going to be how much? 2 pi FS, right? Because when the machine is not rotating, how much is the frequency in the rotor? Is FS, right? So how much is X? It's going to be 2 pi F times F. When the machine is rotating, how much is the frequency? Is SFS, right? So basically, omega is going to be 2 pi mu F times F. So, and LB, we call it inductance of rotor per phase when the rotor is not moving. Block rotor inductance. Block rotor inductance. Perfect.
Yeah, wait, let me see what you're writing.
Rotor winding leakage inductance. We call it rotor winding leakage inductance. LB. LB is a rotor winding leakage inductance. Now, again, what's the relation between XR and XB? XR is 2 pi FR LB, right? XB is 2 pi FS LB. See, it doesn't matter if the rotor is rotating or not, the inductance of winding is fixed. How much of it is LB? You call it LB, right? But the impedance is different, right? And what's the relation between FR and FS? So basically, XR is equal to SXP, right? How about the resistor? Does it matter if it's rotating or not?
No.
It doesn't have anything related to frequency, right? If it's rotating, it's RR. If it's not rotating, it's RR, right? So there is no difference. Let's say if you are going to call it, you can say RR is equal to RB. RB is the big block rotor. I'm going to use that R. Now I'm going to redraw this circuit. How much is the IR? IR is ER over RR plus JXR. Right? Is it correct? Now, how much is the ER? I'm going to use this equation here. ER is SEB, right? SEB. Oh. How much is RR? RR. We don't have any other things to put. Hold on. How about XR? Right? I'm going to replace it with SXB. Let's divide the both by S. It's going to be EB over RR over S plus JXP. Right? Now I'm going to redraw a new circuit based on this equation. This side, nothing changed. It's going to stay this way. I didn't do anything here, right? Let's redraw it. Okay. Let me draw it and talk. Don't think about this one. This is just what I'm copying from that circuit, right? Look at the second thing. And as I said, my intention is to change from ER to EB. Why? Because EB is when the rotor is not rotating, right? So now I can easily bring this parameter to the primary, like a regular transformer. But before going there, is this one correct? How did I write, how did I draw that circuit over? Look at this equation. I'm saying IR is equal to EB over this impedance, right? RR over S plus JXB. This is the RR over S plus JXB, right? This is my impedance. How much this voltage should be? EB, right? If that voltage is EB and that impedance is RR over S plus XB, the current is how much?
IR.
The current is IR. The same IR I had here. See, the current has stayed the same. I can change the current. But the voltage is I changed from ER to EB.
If S is one, then what is the other?
No. When I said what's E, blah, no, it's not. That circuit for one case, I said EB, if you want to define it, is when the rotor is not rotating, right? Which S is equal to 1. So basically, in that case, if the rotor is not moving, right? EB and ER, they are the same. But in general, you know, I don't know, rotor is rotating 1000 RPM, 2000 RPM, ER is equal to SEB, right? If you put S1, this is the equation we have here, right? When does it stop? Clear that circuit is clear? How did I draw that circuit? I use this equation, IR equal to EB over RR over S plus JXP to draw that part of the circuit. Now, the good thing about this one, I have one resistor here, one impedance here, and this is exactly like transformer. Why? Because it's the E block, right? When the winding is not moving. I can bring this one easily here, right? Like a regular transformer. If I want to bring them here, it's going to be this one times A squared, and this one times the A squared, right? That's the transfer, you know, rule we use for when we move the impedance from one side of the transformer to the other side of the transformer, right? Now, let's call this one I1. If I want to, actually, I don't want to call it I1, let's call it. So, what's the relation between I1 and IR? Yeah, if we're going to write it, it says I1 over IR is equal to this one over A, right? Something like this, right? It says I1 over I2 is N2 over N1, right? So basically, I1 is IR over A. How about E1 and EB? E1 over EB is equal to A over 1, right? So, E1, EB. Now I'm going to redraw this circuit, bring everything to a state. I want to bring it to the state. The equivalent circuit of the induction machine referred to the stator side. So how, what is going to be? It's going to be like this. This one is RS, XS, IS, VS, RC, XM, IV, IM, IC. Now, this one. This one is going to come here, right? It's going to be R prime R and X prime B. And this is the I prime R. Everything came to the stator side. How much is R prime R? How much is R prime R? A square. Right? RR over S. Let's not call it R prime R. Let's call it, let's call this one R2. Let's call this one, I prime R. Let's call this one R prime 2. And this one, call it X prime, 2. Give them this name. So R prime 2, R prime 2 is going to be A square RR over S, right? Or you can call A2 this part, call it R prime R over S. A square R, call it R prime, right? R prime R. So basically the resistance in the stator side is going to be R prime R over S. How much is R prime R? Is A squared RR, right? Mm-hmm. Correct?
Yes.
How about X prime 2? How about X prime 2?
A squared JXB.
And A squared, right? Mm. I should have called this one. Sorry, I should have called this one X prime R. This one is prime R. X prime R is A squared XB, right? So basically the circuit is like this. And we have a VS, this is an AC, RS, XS, R prime R over S. You can put it all, you can put the other one also here. You can say this is X prime R, right? And this is about I prime R. And this is the I. And this is the I. This is an equivalent circuit of the induction machine per phase A, for example. All referred to the stator side. Remember in the exam I asked you to draw the circuit in the high voltage side? Here I'm drawing the circuit into the stator side. Everything went to the stator side. That's the reason this time they have prime. Means they are not in their circuit. They are being moved to the stator side. And I write it here again. R prime R is A square RR, and X prime R is A square XP. Right? And this is the kind of summary. Prime R, how much was the I prime R? I had it somewhere here. is this one. IR over A. Many circuits, they ignore this one. They ignore this one, just take the XM here. If they send approximate model of the machine, just get rid of this one. This one is not there, like a transformer, you know. But this is a complete model of the one phase of the induction machine.